In a major global health threat, many dangerous infections are no longer treatable with antibiotics. That's because the drugs no longer kill the bacteria making people sick. Each year, antibiotic-resistant bacteria infect at least 2 million Americans and kill more than 23,000. Nyana Nyana Karen and his team at Los Alamos National Laboratory are working to solve that problem before we're left without any effective antibiotic drugs.
Antibiotic resistance is when bacteria find a way to make the drugs not so effective. We need to first ask the question that how do bacteria become resistant to drugs? Bacteria, they do it in many different ways. Efflux pumps are molecular machines you find on the surface of the bacteria, mainly the gram-negative bacteria, and they function by getting the drugs which get inside the bacterium, they pump them out. So the drugs don't have enough time to stay and act on where they're supposed to act and kill the bacteria. These efflux pumps are one of the most dominant mechanisms that leads to drug resistance.
To figure out how to disable the pumps, Los Alamos National Laboratory recently simulated how the pumps work at a single atom level on supercomputers. Using those simulations, researchers at Los Alamos, the University of Oklahoma, and Goethe University in Germany are studying ways to deactivate the pump. That would mean that antibiotics that haven't worked in a long time might be useful again.